threat feeds for Curera, which of them are free, which of them require a subscription, what the benefits and limitation of every one of those. So let's start with the free stuff that you get in Curera. We'll include some filters. Sometimes the rules, as we will see later, has AQL calls that question the X-Force about multiple things. In many cases, has a lot to do with categorization. In order for you to have this working in your Curera system, you need to make sure that in your admin tab, you go to system settings, and you should have this enable X4 threat intelligence fee set to yes. Okay. What is it that you get when you do that? But before that, even start with that, as everything on my channel, this is my personal view, what I have learned from this. But that I'm not representing either IBM, the X-Force, or any of the other threat feeds that I will be talking about here. And to search for those rules, we're going to be using the Use Case Manager app, that free app that is I have done so many videos about. It's fantastic. But we're going to modify by clicking on that gear. We're going to add an extra column that is going to show us where the package is coming from. What is the content extension or app in the App Exchange that gave me those rules? Generally speaking, when it doesn't have any content extension name in here, that typically represents being a rule that came with Curera itself. Okay, so first was in 2007, and the last modification was then. So if we search for all the rules that have the word force, again, I don't know if it's X-4 or X-Force, I just put the word force, and it finds several rules, 20 of them. And if we click onto anyone, I'm actually click on this one, we see in the logic that it says the destination IP is categorized by the X-Force as anonymization services. That thing is automatically fed by the X-Force. You don't have to do anything. That filter will work for you. But notice that it has in here something that says confidence level greater than 75. Why is that confidence business thing in here? Well, the free stuff that comes with Curera, this one, basically the X-Force is acting more like a relay of all the information that it gathers from itself and from other third parties, and that provides information about what things happening out there. But that data is not curated. It's not that they had validated each and every one of those. So that's where you need to go with this confidence level. And you'll see some rules that have 75, 85, and even higher. So if you get the case in which some of these things are firing and after you investigated that that's a false positive, perhaps you need to raise that the confidence level. In fact, if you want to see all those, what you can do is I can actually clear all the filters, and you can search in here on the test definition, in the logic that is being evaluated, if there were, in fact, with that should be categorization, category, everything should go in there. And then you should find all the rules, you see there are quite a bit of them, that has in the test condition something to do with the categorization. Some of these, you know, are filters that comes from the X-Force. But if you want to be sure about it, well, perhaps you can use two filters, and in the rule name we put back the word force, and then that's going to definitely give us those from the X-Force that have some sort of a category in it. We can click on this one, for example, and we see that it's similar, but the filter in here has a different name, and the confidence level here is 75. If we look at another one, let me click on this one. I believe this is an AQL one. Yes, this is an example in which the query is done when the evaluation of the rule reaches this test condition, and then it performs that AQL query into the X4 asking, well, is this URL part of that botnet command and control servers? And here on the right, we see that all of these are from the threat monitoring content extension or application that you get from the X4 Exchange. This one are not coming from the, and this one is crypto mining endpoint content extension. So you can see, you know, where, what is it, what's the package that contains such a rule. And always remember that in the use case manager, even if you don't have it installed, if you click in here, this option, that's going to perform a call and see, okay, you may not have it in here, but it is available for you on the X4. Next, we're going to talk about some standard reference sets that come already in QReader, but they are not populated by default. These are, we can use to look for those, the nice reference data management app, and look for any one of those. So for example, if I put botnet IPs, notice that it finds, and this is the one in particular, has nothing automatically populated to it. I've done a video, you can look in the PDF for it, that show how you can define a stick and taxi feed. So let's say that you have a taxi feed from a service that provides information. Well, you can actually make it point into this, any one of these reference sets, so the data will be there. So you have data coming from stick and taxi, whatever it means, into that reference set. How do I find the rules that were with it? Well, one way of finding that, so for example, if these are things that have to do with malware, hopefully in the rule name, there will be the word malware in it. And you can go here on the test condition and expand them all and say which of them work with a reference set and apply the filter and see all the options you may have. And if I go, for example, looking for one that has indication with IPs, and this should be this one, that address might be the IP address. That's the name of the package. Let's look at that one. Yep, this rule from that package works with that reference set, right? Let's move on and talk about something far more useful and easier to use. So we are talking about the ATPF, Advanced Threat Protection Feed. And this is basically another name for the Threat Intel app, which I have a trial version, and I want to show you how to use it. Let's go there. So if I go into my Threat Intelligence app, actually, let me do it on another screen, so I leave this this entry here. I have spoken about this fantastic app before. You can do the basic, you know, search for a particular collection if you are interested. Again, any one of these. And the beauty of this is when you click Scan Now, it's also called the Am I Affected feature, it will perform an AQL search with all those URLs, four in here, that's not hard, but in this one, there are quite a bit more. If you want to see if any of those phishing URL has been on your network, you click here, that will take you to your log page with that AQL built for you, and you can go back as many days as you want, you can save that search. It's actually pretty good. But what we are talking here today is this feature of the Threat Intelligence app. This, as you can see, when I click right now, I have mine set up to do refresh every 24 hours. If we click here on that gear icon, every 24 hours, it's recommended that when you have this, you'll put it around 1 hour, because this is how often the X4 keep updating this data. Now, what you'll see is this thing puts into all these reference sets that begins with XFE, and I believe that's X4's Exchange. Wonderful and curated data. There's no confidence level thing in here. This, you can take them to the bank. The X-Force will do a good job putting stuff there and taking stuff out. And as you can see, these are command and control servers, anonymizer, botnet, crypto mining. I mean, there are a whole bunch of them. These are IP addresses and URLs. I don't think that right now they have any hashes, but I will not be surprised if they do put this included for that. Now, how do I take advantage, or how do I find the rules that work with those reference set that get automatically populated for me? Now that's easy. As you can see, this is a subscription version. I have a trial for it. And by the way, nothing prevents you from having also stick and taxi feeds putting data in those same reference sets. If you trust that data, the more the merrier. So in order for search, which rules actually do use those XFE, that cannot be simple to find. So what we're going to be doing here in the use case manager is use, for example, I can put into the test condition, does it has the word XFE, and does it works with a reference set? Put those conditions and see what is it that I find. And here there are some rules. There are many more than these, by the way, but here we can find some. Let's explore some of these rules. This one is very straightforward. It's pointing into that XFE reference set, but also on the standard ones that I mentioned before. So if it's in any one of those, this rule is already working for you. Same thing, I believe, on this one, right? Working with those two URLs. Now, let me show you an example. If I put here one, this I've seen it before, actually on the name. What am I doing? Communication with a potential hostile. I'm also going to put the condition that works on a reference set, and I apply that filter. I find, well, for some reason that reference set filter didn't help here, but if I just put the name of that communication with a potential hostile host, and we click on anyone, we see the package where that one came. We see that there's no reference to the XFE entries because they are pointing themselves, they have been pointed by this building block. But if we click on the building block, we see all those entities pointing, the XFE reference set that we saw before, and there are many more, actually. Let's click on the other test condition that we saw here. And we see the combination. So it's not simple to see which was with which. And the beauty is that all those rules are already built. And as soon as you put data into those reference set, either the standard one or this one, you will see that data. You will see those rules working with that data. And in here, since it brings all the building blocks as well, you can click in it and you see, look at that. I mean, all those tables being referenced automatically for you. So when you get the Threat Intelligence app, you get those rules, you get that data being populated, and the stuff is just working for you. It does require a subscription, though. For this conversation to be complete, there is another thing called the X-Force API subscription. And this can be used within QRadar or outside QRadar. However, I don't have a trial license to understand this one, so I'm not going to be doing anything more than mentioning that it exists. And if I get to know something more, I will do another video. So I hope that this gives you an idea on how you can leverage threat feeds in your QRadar rules. As you can see, at no point I mentioned writing your own rule, which you can do, but who has time for that? I mean, if it's already they already come on those packages, why not having it? And remember, once more time, when you are searching for those, remember that nice filter that allows us to see what else I may not have installed, because in my demo system I have a bunch of stuff, but if you don't have them, by just clicking in here you will know that it exists and you can bring it over.